Hello students, today let us learn about wave function and also derive the time dependent form of Schrodinger equation. First of all, what is wave function? We have already studied about the concept of matter waves proposed by de Broglie. So according to this concept, every particle or matter has a wave associated with it whose wavelength is given by h by p. So this wave, that is the matter wave that is associated with every particle, can be described using a function called wave function. So this characterizes the de Broglie waves. It is often denoted by psi, and this function will contain the complete information about the particle. It is usually a complex function. So if suppose a particle is moving along the x direction, then the wave function of such a particle moving along x direction can be written as a psi equal to a e raised to minus I omega into t minus x by v. Here omega is the angular frequency of the wave, v is the velocity of the wave, a is a constant, t means the time, x is the position. So psi bar of x is a function that tells us the probability that a particle is at a position x bar. So we will understand more about the importance of psi later. First of now, let us understand that this wave function describes a matter wave in a mathematical form. It is a complex wave function. Why is it called complex? Because it contains psi. This is an oscillatory function. And we have also understood about the basic terms here, which is omega. Omega is the angular frequency. Then v is the velocity. These are the characteristics of the wave. Then in addition to that, t and x are variables. T is the time, x is the position, a is a constant, and psi is the overall wave function. Now let us try to derive the time-dependent Schrodinger equation. So before that, let us define some basic equations relating angular frequency. If omega is known, the angular frequency and the frequency nu are related by omega equal to 2 pi into nu. Similarly, if velocity is given, then the frequency is related by v equal to nu into lambda. V is the velocity, nu is the frequency, and lambda is the wavelength. Then let us rewrite the previous equation, the wave function, in terms of nu and v. Our wave function psi is psi equal to a e raised to minus I omega into t minus x by v. So instead of this omega, I am going to substitute 2 pi nu, which is a e raised to minus I into 2 pi nu into t minus 2 pi nu x by v. So taking 2 pi as common, a e raised to minus I 2 pi into nu t minus, we know nu by v is 1 by lambda. Nu by v will be 1 by lambda. So it is x by lambda. Now let us rewrite this equation in terms of energy and momentum. So for that, we know frequency and wavelength have a relationship with energy and momentum. So they are given by frequency equal to E by H, because E equal to H nu, so nu equal to E by H. Similarly, we have lambda equal to H by P. So these equations can be substituted here for lambda as well as nu to get the wave function in terms of energy and momentum. So substituting like that, we can get psi equal to a e raised to minus I 2 pi into E by H into t minus x by h by p, which is px by h. Now taking this 1 by h as common, it is a e raised to minus I 2 pi by h into et minus px. So we know h by 2 pi is h cut. So instead of this h by 2 pi, let me substitute h cut in the denominator. So it is a e raised to minus I minus I by h cut into et minus px. So we have modified the wave function and written it in the terms of energy and momentum. We have made a few substitutions in terms of frequency, energy and momentum. So this is the wave function in terms of E and P. Now let us try to formulate the Schrodinger equation using this basic equation. For that, let me differentiate this wave function psi with respect to x twice. So differentiate psi with respect to x twice. So first let us do d psi by dx or dou psi by dou x. What will be the answer? This is an exponential term. You just multiply with the coefficient of x here, which is I p by h cut into a e raised to minus I by h cut into et minus px. Here the coefficient of x is minus I by h cut into minus p, which is I p by h cut. You just have to multiply with that constant, that coefficient. Now taking the differentiation once again, we can find dou square psi by dou x square. So differentiate this d psi, dou psi by dou x once again with respect to x. So you will have to multiply again with the coefficient of x here. That is how you do the differentiation of exponential term, right? If it is e raised to 2x, what is d by dx of e raised to 2x? 2 e raised to 2x. Just multiply with the coefficient of x. So that is what we have done here. So I am going to multiply once again with the coefficient of x in the exponential term. So the answer will be I p by h cut the whole square into a e raised to minus I by h cut into et minus px. So what is I square? I square is minus 1. So this is minus p square by h cut square into a e raised to minus I by h cut into et minus px. So we know this term is simply psi itself. So I can write this as h cut square minus h cut square into dou square psi by dou x square is equal to p square psi, right? I have taken this h cut square to the left hand side and negative sign also to the left hand side. So this will simply look as minus h cut square into dou square psi by dou x square equal to p square psi. So let us number this equation as our equation number 1. Now let us move on. Now let us try to differentiate the wave function psi. Suppose this is our equation A with respect to time. So dou psi by dou t, what will be the derivative with respect to time? Simply multiply with the coefficient of t here. So it will be minus I e by h cut into a e raised to minus I by h cut into et minus px. Simply multiply with the coefficient of time in the exponential factor. So this is minus I e by h cut into psi itself. So we have got the time derivative of this wave function, which is dou psi by dou t equal to minus I e by h cut into psi. We have two equations here. Equation 1 is the derivative with respect to x taken twice. which is minus h square square tau square psi by dou x square equal to p square by psi, sorry, p square psi. And with respect to time, we have taken another derivative. Now let us combine these two equations, equation 1 and 2, to get the time-dependent Schrodinger equation. For that, let us think, what is the equation relating energy and momentum? We know, for particles that are moving with small velocities when compared to light, the total energy of the particle is given by the sum of kinetic energy, which is half mv square, and the potential energy, which is V. That will be the total energy. So we know, in order to represent kinetic energy, we usually use half mv square, but this half mv square can also be represented as m square into v square by 2m, multiply the numerator and denominator by n, which is p square by 2m. So this is another representation of the kinetic energy. So this is equal to p square by 2m plus v. So the relationship between the total energy and the linear momentum is given by this equation for a free particle moving with smaller velocities. Now let us multiply this equation by psi. So our new equation will be E psi equal to p square by 2m into psi plus v psi. We have derived the equation for E psi and p square psi in equations 1 and 2, right? So equation 1 gives the equation for p square psi, which is minus h cut square into dou square psi by dou x square. Similarly, from equation 2, you can calculate the equation for E psi. What will be E psi? E psi will be minus h cut pi I into dou psi by dou t. So these two equations can be substituted into our new equation relating energy and momentum. So instead of E psi, let us write minus h cut by I into dou psi by dou t, which is E psi. Now instead of p square psi, we have minus h cut square into dou square psi by dou x square. We have additional 2m in the denominator, so divide by 2m will be the right term, plus v psi. So this is the final modified equation that we have derived from the equation for psi and the later substitutions. Now let me modify this equation to get the final answer. On the left hand side, multiply the numerator and denominator with an additional I. So in the denominator we have I square, and in the numerator we have minus I. What is I square? I square is minus 1. So minus of minus I will be the new term, which is I itself. So instead of minus 1 by I, we will have I. Minus 1 by I is I itself. So making that change in the left hand side, I can rewrite the equation as I h cut dou psi by dou t is equal to minus h cut square by 2m into dou square psi by dou x square plus v psi. So this is our Schrodinger equation, time dependent form of Schrodinger equation in one dimension, because this equation contains the x term alone. That is why this is a one dimensional equation. So in the case of three dimension, the time dependent Schrodinger equation in three dimension can be written as I h cut into dou psi by dou t is equal to minus h cut square by 2m. Instead of taking the derivative with respect to x alone, take the derivative with respect to x, y and z. So it is dou square psi by dou x square plus dou square psi by dou y square plus dou square psi by dou z square. So this is the three-dimensional case plus v psi. So this is the time-dependent Schrodinger equation. Time-dependent Schrodinger equation in three dimension. So here V is the potential energy of the particle, and V will also be a function of x, y and z. So in this lesson, we have tried to understand what is a wave function. A wave function is a mathematical representation of a particle wave, and its usual mathematical representation is given by this function, a complex function. And using this complex function, we derive the time-dependent Schrödinger equation, which is given by this final equation, if it is a three-dimensional case, and given by this equation, if it is a one-dimensional case. I hope this portion is clear for you. Thank you.